Well, there's only one king of Rio de Janeiro, and you are looking at him, Jose Aldo, making the walk here for yet another big, high-profile UFC fight.
One, if not the greatest featherweight of all time, is Jose Aldo. Not often do I get starstruck, but to watch Aldo make the walk in Rio is truly a one-of-a-lifetime experience. I'm glad I got to do it. He is a star of the highest order. Aldo's title run was something to behold. It was so special.
Oh, yeah.
Every time you watched him, you knew that the fight could end at any moment, and you knew that you were watching one of the most skilled fighters across the board.
And the reason, the primary reason most believe he is the best featherweight of all time, 7 successful defenses, to your point, in that first reign as the UFC featherweight. Well, a special feel in this arena tonight for more reasons than one, but of course, the centerpiece is the former two-division UFC champion, the future Hall of Famer, Conor McGregor, returning to the proven ground here tonight. He fought 3 times in 2016, just once in 2018. Everybody's excited to see what version of Conor McGregor shows up here tonight.
There are more Irish flags in the building than you'll find anywhere in the United States of America, and it's all for the notorious one. Conor McGregor has taken his country, put it on his back, and rode it to superstardom. He is a fantastic fighter, has really good takedown defense, which allows him to keep the fights on the feet where guys are always in danger. You're constantly in danger whenever you're fighting Conor McGregor, because the moment you attack, that counter left hand is like a piston, and he can shut your lights out with one strike.
Yeah, that McGregor counter left hand, truly one of the best weapons in mixed martial arts today. A master when it comes to movement and distance management. And also just rising to the occasion, right? When all eyeballs are on him, and you've experienced this as well, the ability on fight night to shine.
All the distractions, Conor is able to shut him out, and he goes into the octagon, is focused, and always gets the job done.
Our tale of the tape for this featherweight fight. Aldo is 7 years his senior. McGregor is 2 inches taller. He will have a 4-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the official introductions. We go inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
The main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. It's time! 5 rounds in the UFC featherweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer, holding a professional record of 31 wins, 8 losses. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, presenting the former UFC featherweight champion of the world, Jose Aldo Jr. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 16 wins, 2 losses. He stands 5'9" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, fighting out of Dublin, Ireland, the notorious Conor McGregor!
You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
Ready. You ready to fight?
Well, Jose Aldo has wanted to get his hands on Conor McGregor for more than 5 years. They will finally rematch here tonight. Round 1 is underway. McGregor Aldo at 2, your thoughts?
I mean, it can't live up to that. The moment of the first fight, when Aldo went down, McGregor jumped on the fence, you understood that this was just something different. That would never happen again in mixed martial arts. How can they top it? They're about to attempt that right now.
Well, he's got the reach advantage. You might as well use it. Nice job there to find a home for that jab. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Nice punch by McGregor. They're certainly getting after it early. Well, he's certainly keeping busy, DC, connecting with most of the punches he's thrown.
I mean, punches and punches. He's doing a great job.
Ooh-wee!
Ooh-wee, what a right hand by this young man.
Ooh, that uppercut landed for him. All about that left kick to the body. Slips the shot. Swing and a miss by Aldo.
Dig deep, dig deep.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Oh, that's a big connection there for McGregor, DC.
I mean, big strike landed for Ireland's favorite son, Conor McGregor.
So as we pull up some numbers here, we'll get 29 total strikes. Have found the mark for Conor McGregor.
You can really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks. Powerful leg kick landed.
Throwing with authority. Well-placed kick there by McGregor. Aldo's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. That one appeared to stun him.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh! Huge right hand!
He's done!
Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively, protecting his head, raising the guard, and really frustrating the offensive fighter a little bit.
Lesson one in boxing class, hands up, chin down. Beautiful kick.
Oh, landing a punch with the left hand now, so certainly putting it all together on the feet tonight.
Doing a lot of work with his offhand.
Aldo gets caught with that punch. Some fighters shy away from checking a leg kick. Check that one. Ooh.
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish his fight.
Oh.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Both guys landing big shots. Man, he keeps on coming with these shots to the liver, looking to buckle him once again. Certainly buckled him earlier in the fight. He knows he's hurt there. Oftentimes it takes just one to get his opponent down to the canvas.
Oh, he hurt him!
Whoa!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent very bad.
He closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. Man, I don't know how you guys eat elbows like this. I know you try not to, but there is no pad, no glove, no nothing on it.
Oh! Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Well, we talked about his reach advantage off the top. Made good use of it there with that punch, DC. Whoa! Aldo goes for the clinch here, and this is just a mean.
So a strong 5 minutes down.
So let us now check out some of the action in that round, DC. There was a whole lot of it, including a stunner upstairs that nearly closed the show.
It was a lot of action. It was back and forth action, but the big moment was that big strike to the head that landed that put him on wobbly legs and in survival mode. Luckily, he made it to the end of that round.
Ready.
All right, round two.
Nice punch land. There's no give on that leg kick.
Oh, and he lands yet another strike to the body. Pinpoint placement right underneath the elbow. So he counters with an effective punch there, and at least in that situation, it paid to have the advantage in reach. Very nice outside leg kick by him there, DC. We'll see if he follows it up here.
He's really driving his shit.
Whoa!
Newsberg, throws him up. Go get him.
Well, he's up, but he is hurting for certain. The finish could come at any time. Well, Conor McGregor looking the part of mixed martial arts superstar as usual tonight. He has navigated the A-list celebrity status pretty well, all things considered. Everybody wants a piece of this guy, the talk shows. But one thing that always seems to be at the heart of Conor McGregor, the work ethic, the MMA discipline really has never waned. Missed with that right hand.
Big, powerful punch land. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, a huge block there.
Relax, relax. Keep your hands up for him.
Well, the right hand has been there at times, not that time.
He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Still unable to find that precise range with the high kick. And they separate. Aldo gets hit with a kick. That one appeared to land flush. Slips. Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad. He's getting lit up right now, John.
Oh, straight right. Oh! Man.
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
So the unofficial numbers, they are good. 95 total strikes have now landed for Conor McGregor. And connecting at a 44% clip tonight, DC, against Jose Aldo. Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found the rhythm and found his striking range. Scary proposition for the opponent now here in round two. Oh, he landed a beautiful straight punch there, DC. He's got an edge in reach and certainly is making it count in this one. Just over 2 minutes to go in round two. Yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet.
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, he might be out.
Hands high, hands high.
Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense?
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Oh, and another leg kick lands flush, and now you're starting to see visible damage on that lead leg of his opponent.
Visible damage, and you see him starting to make mistakes now in his defenses because his leg is so beat up. It's red, it's all beat up, he's limping, he's turning away. There are so many things that he is doing wrong now because of the leg damage he has taken. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
And he landed the right hand there. Under a minute now in round two. All right, 45 seconds now to go in the round.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Oh! Unbelievable. pretty good work with the strikes.
What a fight so far.
All right, that's the end of 5 minutes. That's the end of the round. You see the cut on his lip, and that thing is only getting worse. Pretty nasty gash at this point in time. You know he's going to need some sutures after the fact. The focus right now, though, keeping his head in the game. Don't think about the cut. You got to think about getting your offense going and shoring up that defense to prevent that cut from getting any worse. All right, so his legendary chin holds up despite getting knocked down in that previous round. DC, take us through the highlight.
He's as tough as they come. There has not been a guy that can take shots like this. Most times the night would be over, and gladly, gladly over after you take a shot like this. But this man is just too tough. Some people say he's too tough for his own good. He would not agree with you. He wants to fight.
Punches in bunches, and he hasn't really shown any signs of slowing down here tonight. I'm not sure how much more his opponent can take.
Oh! He's hurt. Serve him up.
Another shot, Lance. Can you believe it?
He's done. He's done. What a performance.
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're the referee, you got to protect the fighter, and I thought he did a good job of doing just that. So a big win for him here tonight, and an even bigger statement made by virtue of the TKO.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 15 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by TKO, Jose Aldo Jr.
Well, could you imagine what the celebration is like in his hometown right now after he gets the TKO win tonight? He said he wanted to leave the judges out of it. Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished. He left the judges out of it. The judges could have went to the concession stand, because once he got his opponent hurt, he was not going to stop until he got that TKO.